Hi, and welcome to the Snagit 2018 reveal. I'm Andrea Perry, and I'm going to be hosting you today. With me is Tony Dunkel, Snagit's General Manager.
Hey, everyone.
Today we'll talk about Snagit's new name, when you can get your hands on the new version, and then we'll jump right into the demo and show you what's coming. So, Tony, tell us what happened to the version number.
You bet. So it's amazing. Snagit has been around for nearly 30 years. Isn't that crazy? Traditionally, we've named Snagit in numerical order per platform. So for example, the latest version of Snagit was version 13 on Windows and version 4 on Mac. But after 30 years, those numbers start to lose meaning to customers. They often don't know if they're on the latest version or not because they don't have any idea if version 13 was the last version released. So by switching to a year-based naming system, we're hoping to accomplish a few different things. First, we want to make it easier for users to know if they're on the current version. Two, as we continue to grow parity between Mac and Windows, we want to eliminate confusion between the different version numbers across the two platforms. And last, we're signaling to the market that we are moving to a more rapid release cadence to keep pace with the changes in the fast-moving industry we live in. So we're excited to bring this new change to Snagit and looking forward to a fantastic release. But the big question is, when can people get their hands on the new Snagit 2018? So in terms of release date, Tuesday, October 24th is the date you want to mark in your calendars. That's the day that Snagit 2018 will be available to the public.
That's great. For those who have just joined the stream, welcome. We're talking about the upcoming release of Snagit 2018, which Tony just told us will be available on Tuesday, October 24th for both Mac and Windows. If you're wondering whether or not this is a free or paid upgrade, this is a free upgrade for anyone under active maintenance and for those who have purchased in the last 30 days. If you meet one of those qualifications, TechSmith will email you to let you know how you can get your hands on a free upgrade. If you qualify for a free upgrade and don't receive an email, you might want to check your spam folder. The email may have landed there. Otherwise, this upgrade is $24.95 if you've purchased any prior version. Snagit 9, 10, 11, we don't care. And then it's $49.95 if you're a brand new customer. If you purchase maintenance when you buy, which is just $12.49, you'll get a free year of upgrades, priority support, a master key, and a discount on volume licensing. So lots of reasons to add that to your purchase.
Thanks, Andrea. So now with no further ado, let's take a look at Snagit 2018. To do that, we're going to turn things over to Chris and Daniel, who will walk you through the new capabilities as well as the problems they aim at solving.
Hi, we're here to talk about the next release of Snagit. With this release, we're really focused on a few different groups and the pain points and the problems that they've described to us. One is technical communicators, second is trainers, and third is anyone really creating technology that can be engineering or testing, or people doing education or marketing or onboarding for a technical product. We're continuing to work on themes that we've addressed over the past couple of years in Snagit 13 and 4, but we're going much deeper in some areas in the next version that we're calling Snagit 2018. First off, we've heard a lot from folks that they really want to be able to grab text off the screen. So sometimes you have a really hard to copy and paste thing like an error message or a system dialogue, and copy and paste just simply doesn't work. So we want to solve that problem.
Another use case that we hear about a lot is people that want to grab a list of file names quickly. So here I've taken a panoramic capture. You can see a list of files and the sizes. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to trim off the icons here. I'm going to go to Edit, Grab Text. And once I'm in, it'll process that this image here, and I'll get a results window, which you can edit, you can copy specific things from. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Copy All. And then I'm going to open a spreadsheet, and I'm going to paste it directly in there. And as you can see, once I paste this, it is keeps the table layout, and you can see it has an accurate representation of the files, the date, the file type, and the size. So you can do that and compare against something else, or just store that off for historical purposes.
And another use case for grab text is when you need to repurpose content. Let's say someone sends you a flattened PDF. You don't have the original files, and you just need to get that text out of there. Saves a lot of time. As I mentioned earlier, we're building on features that were introduced in the 2016-17 releases. In this case, the autofill feature, which let you delete content from a screenshot and then fill in the blank space, like digital whiteout.
So we hear a lot about how hard it is to keep your documents up to date as your product changes. So we're going to use this website as an example. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do just a normal image capture. So I'm going to capture this and I'm going to bring it into Snagit. So now that it's in editor, what I'm going to do is I'm on the move tool here. I'm going to check the smart move button. And what that's going to do is it processes the image, it looks for text and objects. And as I hover over things, you can see it's kind of recognized them for you. So you can tweak the level of detail that you get. Here, I'm going to move it up a little bit. It's going to reprocess that image. And as you can see, as I mouse over things, it can accurately guess the areas that you have text and images on and other objects. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move these objects around. And what happens now is I have an image that all I had to do was click and drag. It auto-filled the background, and I have something ready to send off to people on my team.
As you can see, we make it really easy to move shapes and text around just by hovering and click and drag. And it really feels like magic when you use it.
Yeah, there are a lot of things that are going on in the background there, and we don't have a whole lot of time to get into them today, but we're bringing together some powerful technologies. For instance, OCR, computer vision, and that content-aware fill that we introduced in the last release. But we're bringing that to you with the Snagit-style simplicity that you know and love.
And sometimes it's not just about moving or deleting things. So maybe you need to make a quick update to some text in your screenshot, and you don't want to have to go back and retake that screenshot.
So let's say the text in your product interface changed. So I'm going to use that same website as an example. I'm still in the Move tool and on Smart Move. What I'm going to do is as I mouse over text there, I just double click it, and it takes the text out. It puts a text object on there for you. It autofills the background, and I can just make my edit right here. So I'm going to type out some text. And then what I'm going to do is, since I'm not exactly happy with the replace that happened there, I can change the font size and any of that like I would with a normal text object.
And just to point out something cool that's really easy to miss, Snagit is actually matching the color and the size of the text and the general font type from the screen. So these are some game-changing features that are simply not found in other image editors. And all of them are coming to Snagit on both Windows and Mac. But you'll also see a lot of smaller refinements in the next version of Snagit.
So on Mac, as you drag things around on the canvas, you'll notice there are these blue lines that appear. And as they appear, you can align them with the canvas itself, but also other objects that you've created. You can also align them with objects that Smart Move has created as well. So this really shines with Smart Move, that you can actually align with things that are in the capture itself.
The snapping feature will be included on Mac right away with the major release, and is planned for a follow-up minor release on Windows. And that's not to say Snagit on Windows isn't getting its own set of refinements. It will now be a 64-bit app and include a number of performance improvements to help you work faster.
You can both capture and edit much larger images. In version 13, you were limited to 5,000 pixels to a side, and now it can handle 24 times as many. We've been making improvements to Snagit video over the past couple of releases to boost quality and performance. And that means silky smooth video without lagging your machine. You're now able to get 4 times as many pixels when recording webcam at 72% of the CPU load and 40% less CPU usage when recording the screen.
The best part of my role is getting to talk to a lot of customers. More than once I've heard people say, "I'm sure it's probably impossible, but," and then they basically describe the capabilities that we just demoed for you. So it's really exciting to be part of a team that is making impossible things not only possible, but easy.
We didn't have time to discuss everything added in this release, but as you can see, customer feedback and ideation play a big role in what we build. So please keep the suggestions coming. We love hearing about the big, ambitious ideas and the small yet significant requests. We'll continue listening and making Snagit better based on what we hear.
We hope everyone is as happy about this new functionality as we are. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them in the comments. Several people are monitoring the chat and will respond to as many of your questions as they can. We've anticipated a few questions you might have, and one of those is regarding the name.
That's right.
Tony, people may think that including the year 2018 means that Snagit is moving to a subscription model. Is the business model changing for Snagit?
No, not at all. Snagit 2018 will remain a perpetually licensed product like we've always had. We know a great many of our customers still appreciate the type of licensing approach. What you can take away from the new naming convention is that we expect to increase our release cadence to better align with the increased pace of the tech industry as a whole, including keeping pace with the release of new operating systems by both Microsoft and Apple. What this means for customers who have subscribed to maintenance is that they'll get even more value for their investment. For those that have not subscribed to maintenance, Maintenance is a great way to always have access to the latest version of Snagit, and you can do so for only 25% of regular MSRP, which typically results in a single user price of $12.50, unless you're on one of our existing discount programs.
Excellent. So no surprises in terms of licensing. Another question. Since Snagit 2018 is a 64-bit app, is the 32-bit app still available for those that may not be running the latest and greatest operating systems?
It sure is. So for Snagit 2018, we're going to default to providing the 64-bit version since that represents the majority of the user base. But for those needing the 32-bit version, it'll be easy to get from the Snagit product section of our website at techsmith.com.
Great. Thank you, Tony.
You bet.
With that, we're going to wrap up this stream. We'll continue to keep the chat open for questions as long as they keep coming in. And we hope that you'll mark your calendars to catch the release of Snagit 2018 on October 24th. I want to thank you for joining us today. You can share this video from the Snagit Facebook page. And to be contacted when Snagit 2018 goes live, you can sign up for an email notification using the link above.